Of you. Today I am here to present some tips in Magento development, which will be very helpful for developers, I think. So we can start from here, like what are the best practices we can follow in Magento to get it better and better output from Magento in our website to make it more powerful. So here is the agenda of my presentation. Is first I can introduce like why we need to do this best, why we need to follow all these best practices in Magento. After that, I can share some best practices in which I can compare what is the wrong we are doing and what is the correct way we can do. And after that, we can conclude some points. So in introduction, like I can say, Magento Experts Consultancy Group, ECG, which is known as ECG, has conducted many code audits for their clients, and they find some coding issues. That's why their stores are very taking high loads. And so from about 28% of the issues affected performance and scalability of the code. And the top five performance coding issues represent 84% of the performing issues. So most of the issues are related to insufficient operations, redundant or useless computations, and memory misuses. So among five, these are the calculating the size of an array on each iteration of a loop. So whenever we use a for each loop, at the time we calculate the size of the array. So I can explain all these points in the further slides. And after that, the SQL queries inside a loop, loading the same module multiple times, redundant data set utilization, insufficient memory utilizations. So these are the major findings by the Magento itself. So these are the, you can say it's this PPT is given from Magento also. So here, first is calculating the size of the array on each iteration of a loop. So here you can see, like, if we use a count in four statement, then it is calculating every time as my loop rotates. So what is the good practice is we have to calculate the counts at the first and then just use the variable in the for each iteration. So it will be very fast. And after that, SQL query inside a loop. We can say, like, in Magento's, we can load models to get data. Like, it's an example, like if I need to get a product data, then I need to load my model, which is actually hitting the database. So here you can see for each loop, I have multiple number of IDs, and I am in each iteration, I am hitting the database to calling the models. So instead of this, we have to calculate our model outside the loop and then just iterate the collection. Collection will contain all the data of these product IDs which I have passed here. So this is the best practice we can use here. And after that, the loading the same model multiple times, like I have to show some SKU, my product SKU and my product attributes, like color, size, I have to show on front end. Then what usually we prefer is we can load the model, then get the attribute from that product, and again, if I need to get the SKU of that product, then I can again load it. But it will vary time consuming. So we have to follow, like, we have to only load model only once. And from that model, we are already getting all the data. So whatever we have to show, we just have to retrieve from that data instead of loading the same products many times. Or sometimes we no need to load the whole models. Like in Magento, on front end, we have to show only color. I don't need of size and different SKUs, names and different things. So I can just directly load the SKU or the size by ID of the product. So this will only give me the SKU. After that, the memory fetching large result sets. In Magento, or we can say it's a normal PHP, in which we just fetch all the results. Like in my tables, I have a 1 lakh of records. If I will fetch once, it will be my memory usage actually. So it will be a good to calculate a row by row in a loop, in a while loop. I need to fetch actually one row and then process it, then one row, then process it, instead of getting all whole data, which will be a memory actually. And after that, query resulting limitations, we can say. In Magento, whenever we fetch data, we don't use generally limits. Like I have to fetch a user information in which I just already mentioned in model, like particular user data, but instead of not defining the size or the limit, I am fetching the whole data or accessing the whole database to get that particular information. Instead of this, if I will apply some limit or something like in the collection, you can use get limit or set limit something. After that, we can also use get size instead of get count, instead of counts. The difference is here, count will, we can say, scan all the database to get the count every time. And the get size will just give you directly the size of the collection which you have get. So, or overriding the core file, actually, very often developers rewrite the core files when there is a possible way to accomplish the functionality by the observer. Magento have very useful feature and very beautiful feature, which is an event observers. So instead of rewriting the core modules in Magento, we have to use the events. Like whenever any user add the product into the cart, then we have to add or restrict some condition there. Then we don't need to modify the core code in Magento. We already have an event like add to cart after or add to cart before. So at that particular point, you can write the code. Magento will do their functionality without writing the rewrite core files actually. So these are the some basic best practices in Magento. All are not of Magento, are some of from PHP also. Yeah, but we generally use this all in Magento, as Magento is built in PHP and following the Zend framework. So we have to follow all this. And also you can, whenever we have to debug anything in Magento, we have to use the locks instead of like echo exit, in like we did every time in PHP, we write some print r or some using the echo exit to check the execution of the code. So instead of doing this, we can use the locks. In the locks, we can store whatever the flow of our code. So it will not affect the end user also. It will be very useful when we are debugging on the production side. Actually, in production, we cannot just echo exit to test our issues. So we have to write this code in the Magento. We have to write the locks. And it will, everything, whatever you want, it will return in the logs, and you can check the flow, like how your code works and what was the data it was passed. And here you can see the first parameter is what you have to pass. You can pass any variable or any array in that first field. Second is a null, or you can specify 1, 2, or 3, or 4. It's null is a Zend log, and 1, 2, 3 different codes is there in the Magento. One is for alert, and different notifications and different type of values you can pass here. And after that, this is a log file name. You can create your own log files, or Magento already have system.logs and exception.log. You can also store there. But to do this, you don't have to forget to check in if you have enabled the logs in the Magento or not. If you will not enable it, it will not store in the logs. So this is the first thing you have to check. Yeah, so here's the conclusion, like points to be note for the developers. What they have to note: always be attentive for the performance critical code. Actually, whenever we develop, we are not looking into the performance first. Our first idea is to complete the functionality. And after that, we can think about the code performance or not. If it will not affect, then we will not make it changes. But it will work for the small systems. Like I have 50 users or 100 user, 200 user. But whenever my system grows, the actual performance of code will highlight that time. So that time, if I write the wrong codes, which is very performance critical, then at the end, I will be stuck actually. There is no way to make it optimized. They will be very difficult for the user. So from the starting, we have to remember for the performance critical codes in Magento. After that, to avoid the useless computation inside the loops, like we just saw, we have loading the models every time in the loop. So we have to take care, we will not do this. It will significantly improve our Magento performance. And try to learn and understand the feature of frameworks and use them correctly. Like in Magento is a e-commerce, and which is also written in PHP. So we can directly write the core PHP in Magento also. So instead of doing this, we have to understand what the framework is and how to write the code on that particular framework, so that we can utilize the performance or the better benefits or features of that particular framework instead of writing the core codes. And after that, we have to use a common sense. Like sometimes we have to fetch all the data at a time, like if we have a small database table, sometimes we don't have to fetch all the time all data at a time. We have to fetch every row in a for each, which I just saw you. So as per the situation, we have to understand like which code we have to use. Either we have to fetch all at the time, or we have to fetch one by one in a loop. So these are the notes which a developer have to take care whenever they write any code in Magento also. So this is, I cannot say it's purely Magento. It's also a PHP also. So developer have to maintain all these features and keep in mind whenever they develop any modules or anything in Magento. So in the next, this is the part one of the presentations and the best practices in Magento. For the next meetup, I will share many other good feedbacks or good features, like how to implement the things in Magento. So thank you, that's it from my side. Any questions or anything? Yeah.
So it's
a version, sir.
Yeah. Can you replace it with
HHP? No. Actually, I have not tried it because as per the Magento guidelines, they are suggesting to run the PHP from, I think, 5.3 to 7 in the core PHP. So I have not tried it, actually. So, anything else?